Similarly, when Q operates on a wave function and it gives a value and then the wave function back. So we call the such states that every time when Q is operated on this, it gives a value Q, then such states we define as determinate states. And this is operator, these are called the eigenfunctions, and this is the Q's are called the eigenvalues. If there are different values of Q, then all the possible values of these we call is the spectrum, is the spectrum of when all Q's are different, like many Q1, Q2, Q3, these values are possible, then we call all the Q values is the spectrum of the operator Q. And when we are having all the Q values is different from each other, then we call them non-degenerate. We call it a non-degenerate spectrum or non-degenerate values. And when two or more than two values of these means eigenvalues, they are the same, then we call them degenerate spectrum or degenerate values of the state. And for example, when I apply H on psi, then I get E psi. Then psi is called the eigenfunction of H, and E is the eigenvalue of this operator. E is the eigenvalue of the Hamiltonian operator. So let me solve an example, and the example is that consider an operator. This operator is Q and this is equal to I d over d phi, where phi is the polar variable, like we are calling it theta as well. And Q is the first, we will have to prove that is Q Hermitian. So we will have to prove this first, that is Q a Hermitian operator, and what are the eigenvalues and eigenfunctions of Q. What are the eigenvalues and eigenfunctions of this operator Q? So we will have to find them. So the solution of this is, let that f is a function which is defined from 0 to 2 pi, means it's a periodic function. So f of phi will be equal to f of phi plus 2 pi. So we say that the function is finite in the interval when phi is less than or equal to 2 pi is less than or equal to 0. Now we know that the condition for Q to be a Hermitian operator, then we will have to write our condition as we discussed earlier, that F and Q operated on F here, then this will be the same as we operate this here on F and F here. So if this is true for this operator, then we will say that it is a Hermitian operator. We can take like if a function is g a function here, then it will be the same if g is here and q is operated on f. Like mean when it will change from the kit to the bra and the operator is not affected, then it will be the Hermitian operator. Like we can write for this operator that this is true as well if I write f and q operated on g, this is equal to q operated on f here and g here, then this will be a Hermitian operator. So let's start here. Let's take this side and we will prove. So this side is f and it is operated on, the operator is on g here. So let me write this in the integral form. So the functions are defined from 0 to 2 pi and this one I write is a conjugate and then q operator and g and dx. So we have the dx here. Now put the operator here. So from 0 to 2 pi and the operator is this one, f and I d over d phi and g dx. So we will, is the variation is in phi, so we will write here phi, not x. So d phi. Now we will do integrate by parts. So consider this is the first function and this is the second function. So we will do integration by parts and this is equal to first function which is this one into integration of the second function. When integration will apply on this, then the differential will be cancelled and we will get only g here. So I will come out and we are having g from 0 to 2 pi. Then minus whole integration from 0 to 2 pi and then derivative of the first function. So it will become d over d phi of f means derivative of the first function and then integration of the second function. So again the integration will give us I and g here and d phi will come as a whole with this integration. So we know that the value of f or g means it is the same for both the functions. So if I put g at 2 pi minus g at 0, then it is actually the same. So this one will go to 0 and we will have, we are left only with this one and this will, I can write is, if I write this is I d over d phi and I write f with it and I take the conjugate of it. So when I is conjugated, it will become minus I. So I adjust that minus with this one, and then I write 0 to 2 pi and g d phi. So I can write this in the bracket notation. I d over d phi is actually the q operator, and f, as they are in conjugate form, so I wrote them in the bra here, and g is not conjugate, so it go to the kit, and we are having this. So what we did, we proved that when q can come from the kit to the bra unaffected, and so this is actually proved that q is a Hermitian operator. Q is Hermitian. Now the second part of the example is, what are the eigenvalues and eigenfunctions of q? So I will write the eigenvalue problem here, and this is the operator, which is this, and it operates on f, and it will give an eigenvalue, and then f, this implies the operator is id over d phi, and f here, and this is equal to q and f here. Now I can solve this differential equation by moving d phi here and f here, so it will be log of this, and then I can take the exponential, and the solution of this is that f of phi is equal to a constant a and e to the power minus I q phi. This is the solution of this differential equation. And now putting this condition in this equation, that f of phi is equal to f of phi plus 2 phi, so I can write that f of phi is equal to f of phi plus 2 pi. So this is f of phi. I can write this condition implies that a e minus I q phi is equal to a e minus I and q, and then phi plus 2 pi. So what will happen, that this portion a e, this is a I q phi, so I can write that this is a e minus I q phi and multiplied with e minus I q 2 pi. So I see that this one is cancelling with this one, and e minus I q 2 pi is equal to 1. And if I write this in the sine and cosine terms, means I explained this Euler formula, then this is true only when q is equal, when q is equal to 0, means q will take its values and all the 2 pi's, so plus 1, plus minus 2, and so on. And all these q, now I got a spectrum of values. So these are actually called the spectrum of eigenvalues of q. So the operator, the op operator q. So these are all different values. So I will say the spectrum of operator q is non-degenerate, as they are all different values. So f is the eigenfunction, while These are the eigen values of the operator Q.